Well, we've never actually done it, just SYRAH New Zealand versus Northern Rowan. I thought it would be some really interesting matchups, especially considering some of the price differences that are on offer here tonight. So the lineup here is really, really exciting, and all of them are made a little bit differently, but we'll look at the similarities of the vineyards between New Zealand and Northern Rowan, and also some of the similarities and differences in the winemaking styles between the way they make these wines. And then hopefully we can put the two of those together and taste what we've got in the glass and see perhaps what we need to do in New Zealand to maybe reach some of the heights that some of these other wines got. Starting with New Zealand, SYRAH is a variety in New Zealand, is perhaps for a lot of wine writers certainly one of the most exciting and interesting varieties out there. It's not as bad as Riesling, in that Riesling just doesn't resonate with the public at all. Wine writers love it, winemakers love it. It's always going to be the next best thing. It's going to be the next best thing for the last 30 years. They'll keep saying it's going to be the next greatest thing for the next 30, but the public are just never going to buy it en masse. SYRAH, we're slowly coming around to. Certainly, top international wine writers consider it's perhaps the most exciting varietal, certainly in the Hawke's Bay, and that we should pull out all of our Cabernet and Merlot and replant it with SYRAH. Because the advantage of SYRAH in Hawke's Bay, as opposed to perhaps many other New World places, is that it tastes specifically of Hawke's Bay and even the sub-regions in there. And so when you taste New Zealand SYRAH from that region, it doesn't taste like it's from anywhere else in the world. It doesn't taste like Northern Rome, we'll see, is what they say. It certainly doesn't taste like Australian Shiraz or SYRAH from, say, Washington State or from South Africa. So that's the advantage of it, is it has its own personality.